Jedi on the run! As recently rescued Jedi Knight Bas Lashan joins her new companions in escaping terrorists from the Sith fleet, Dark Lord of the Sith, Darth Malak, orders his ships to fire upon the planet Terrace. Barely escaping the chaos, the mysterious Republic crewman is discovered to be one with the Force. Basla then taken the ship to Dantooine to see a mysterious Jedi enclave. The Force-sensitive man is trained as a Jedi apprentice and embarks on his mission to free the nearby grove of a dark cloud in the Force, where his search is interrupted by a gruesome situation.
Ah, the beautiful yet boring Dantooine. If you ignore the vicious Kath Hounds in the area, Dantooine is a peaceful, wonderful planet. The green grass blowing in the wind carrying the refreshing smell of nature. The trees' leaves rustling, the rivers flowing, the faint hum of generators and machinery powering the nearby estates, which despite being man-made, fits the scene splendidly. Across a nearby bridge, however, Dantooine's facade of beauty and nature is shattered by the sins of a man. On that bridge stands Jedi Master Baluk, an orange Twi'lek, talented in the Force like his fellow masters. The Jedi is troubled, however. Surprising considering the man is, well, a Jedi. Approaching him, the Jedi apprentice and his companions can get information on what is going on. Now, I don't expect everyone in the galaxy to understand Hutese, so I'll explain what the Jedi Master is telling us. Baluk addresses us, saying our arrival at this bridge is well-timed, before introducing himself and his purpose in this grove. Baluk is here because of a killing that took place not too long ago. The Jedi Master notes our arrival here and future involvement in this mysterious case could prove as excellent practice for a Jedi in training such as ourselves, and would appreciate some assistance on the case. Baluk reveals there are two suspects in this murder mystery, Handan Guld and Rikard Lusoff, who are both suspected of the murder of a man named Kaldor Nedik. We are to speak to these two men, as well as a crime scene investigation droid on standby, to piece together the puzzle that is this crime scene. Baluk gave us pieces of information that may come in useful to unraveling the mystery. It was cloudy earlier, with little sunlight before the clouds broke, and Handan has been clutching his side oddly since Baluk showed up. We shall keep this info in the back of our heads. It may prove useful in the future. This quest may be done in many ways, but I personally chose to speak to Handan as he was the first to enter my line of sight and appeared to be the closest. Here is what Handan Guld had to say.
Ah, greetings. You must be assisting Master Baluk in his investigation. I'm Handan Guld. Perhaps you've heard of me?
This is a rather odd question to ask, in my opinion. To me, it appears as if Handan is searching for some sort of ally via the Jedi working on this case by attempting to see if the Jedi had heard of him before, so he may get out of this situation scot-free. If he's guilty, this already harms his case a little. I'm going to reply by saying, should I have heard of you, Handan?
I guess under the circumstances, no. Well, I presume you wish to hear my story then. I shall tell you, of course, but there's not much to it. I'm sure that you'll agree that Rickard is quite obviously guilty of murder. You see, I was out here running earlier today. Yes, running. I do that a lot. Can't stand speeders, never use them. Keeps me in shape, too, you know. Anyway, I was out running on the other side of that bridge there, and all of a sudden I heard a shot coming from over here. I ran over and found this man Calder lying on the ground, dead. And I saw Rickard come skulking out of the shadows of the rocks south of the river, and I knew something was wrong. I hit my emergency button and called the Enclave right away. Well, there. That's my story. Now, please hurry this up and arrest Rickard so I can get on with my day.
Handan almost immediately begins accusing Rickard of murdering Calder, which is extremely incriminating. Usually someone childishly trying to throw the blame onto the other party like that is guilty of something. If not murder, then something. He states he was running, which could hold a lining of truth as there's no speeders around to say otherwise, when he heard a shot and found Calder on the ground. That is when Rickard came out of the bush and the Jedi were called. Until we speak to Rickard and compare the stories side by side, we cannot say if Handan is lying or not. The story he tells is completely plausible. I suppose the clutching of his side could be a stitch, but who knows? Let us continue our investigation.
Another Jedi, huh? Helping that Twi'lek investigate, no doubt. You seem stumped.
I'm Rickard Lusoff. Maybe you can figure this out and let me get out of here.
Well, I was out hunting Iriaz when I spotted one over here by the bridge. I pull out my rifle and aim at it. I couldn't see it that well, mind you, because the damn sun was in my eyes. So I shoot it and it drops. I walk over here and find Handen standing over Calder's body. So why don't you get this whole farce over with and send that whiner Handen to the prison he belongs in?
My first impressions indicate that Rickard seems not so confident in Baluk's capabilities to solve this case, as well as displaying his wish to get out of this situation sooner than later, much alike Handen. Already, we can spot out a lie in Rickard's story. He says he was hunting Iriaz but could not see due to the sun, but this can be debunked by the fact it was not sunny at the time. The clouds had not broken until after Baluk got there. This really doesn't paint a very good picture for Rickard, but Handen didn't do so good of a job protecting himself either. The situation is rather mind-splitting. I find myself torn between Handen and Rickard being the killer. Before I report my findings to Master Baluk, I believe it's a safe idea to talk to the droid nearby and retrieve any information it has to offer. We're able to ask the droid about its gatherings of the surrounding area, as well as the body of Caldanetic.
Greetings, apprentice. You must be the one Master Baluk has enlisted to help him with this problem. I am an information retrieval droid. I can assist you by accessing the records of both the Jedi Enclave and the central government facilities here on Dantooine. If you had any need of my services, please do not hesitate to talk to me. I have already retrieved some information from the archives on Caldanetic, Rickard Lusoff, and Handen Gould. I have also had time to examine the body of Mr. Nettie. My preliminary analysis of the body indicates that he was killed approximately 3 hours ago by a single energy blast to the torso. These planes are rife with wild animals, not all of them benign. The Iriaz are mostly docile, but can easily be provoked to violence. Kath Hounds, on the other hand, are much more deadly. There have been over 35 catalogued attacks on settlers by Kath Hounds in the last 2 weeks. A general advisory was given out 3 days ago to carry a weapon at all times when on the plains. Small farms and holdings dot the plains and can provide safe refuge for those in need.
After speaking to the information droid, we can then go back to Master Baluk and tell him of our findings. He swiftly runs us through both stories again, with the possibility of Rickard accidentally shooting Calder and Handen finding the body, though he finds this very unlikely. We can say that we think Rickard is lying because the sun was not out when the murder was first committed nor reported. The clouds broke sometime after Baluk got there. Baluk congratulates us on our findings, and commands us to continue our investigation. Though Rickard was caught in a lie, that does not mean he or Handen can be charged. Which then presses our next point of investigation, motive. We must speak to both Handen and Rickard again, and establish a motive for the killing. Attempt to find a clear one for it, and determine who is truthful, who is lying, and weigh out the motives.
Yeah, I knew him. Hell, we've known each other for a good long time. Doesn't mean I really have to have liked the slime ball. Maybe I shouldn't be so hard on him, especially now that he's dead. We actually got along pretty well most of the time. We just had our differences. We were actually business partners. We were involved in some orbit-to-ground transport operations for Aerotech. Can I leave now? I should probably be the one to give the news to his wife.
Rickard reveals almost immediately that he was well acquainted with the victim, stating he wasn't too fond of him at times, but they got along well most other days and were in fact business partners. Business partners, you say? A possible motive for the murder then, if it was Rickard, is perhaps some shady business dealings he did not like caused Rickard to become infuriated and murder Calder in cold blood, in revenge or for money, which could explain his distasteful demeanor when he was first questioned on his affiliation to Mr. Nettick. This is just a possibility, however, as unless we find actual hard evidence of something Rickard did to Calder, or Calder did to Rickard, in the past which could lend credibility to this theory, we cannot charge Rickard of murder. On the surface, Handen doesn't seem to have much of a motive to kill Calder. However, going to the droid can paint a bigger picture for both Handen's case and Rickard's case. We can ask the droid about Caldanetic's relationship with both Handen and Rickard, based on reports and public information, which may assist us in seeing any lies in any of their tales.
According to the municipal authorities near the Garrow spaceport, there had been news of violent drunken activity in a cantina attached to the port. Apparently, a Mr. R. Lusoff was making accusations at a Mr. C. Netic about cheating him in a business deal. Jedi Tuka was dispatched to the scene and restored order. The Southwood speeder rental business has records that over the past 7 weeks, a speeder had been rented by Mr. Netic and Mr. Gold.
And there we have it. A possible motive for a murder. Rickard was having a drunken argument with Calder at a cantina, about Calder cheating him in a business deal. It is very much looking like Rickard is guilty. However, for someone who doesn't use speeders, I also find it odd that Handan would rent out one with Calder. Perhaps there's more to Handan's story than he lets on. We can confront Handan on this point, as we know fine well that he's lying. He clearly has some closer connection to Calder. I don't know about anybody watching this video, but I wouldn't rent out a speeder with someone I barely knew, especially if I heard really bad stuff about them in conversations with other people.
But I realize this must seem like a motive to you, but I assure you it isn't. I dislike Calder, true. I would punch his face in, given the opportunity, but I would not kill him.
Handan makes a very odd statement regarding Calder, saying he would happily punch his face in, but not kill him. Questioning him further on this reveals the truth.
My wife was cheating on me with him. I slept in my own bed while I was in the next room. But, as much as I may hate him for that, I could not kill him. It may have been my own fault for driving my wife away. I must try not to take the law into my own hands. I was just out running, trying to clear my head for the divorce proceedings, not stalking him to kill him. Running is not a crime.
And here we have Handan's motive. Calder and Handan's wife were having an affair behind Handan's back. Even the fact Handan wished to commit minor acts of violence against him is a clear indication there was rage flowing through him, and a reason to kill him. We'll take this back to Master Baluk. This truly throws a wrench into the works. After revealing to Baluk Handan's secret, he counters a lie with the fact that this may be a motive, but it confirms absolutely nothing, and we should now focus on the weapon used to take out Mr. Netic. We already know from the droid that Calder suffered a single blaster shot to the torso. Let us investigate further. We can inquire with the droid for information on the blaster found at this crime scene.
We cannot get any more specific analysis from that sample, other than the fact it did not belong to Calder.
An interesting turn of events, to be sure. If the weapon did not belong to Calder, who could it have belonged to? Handan is likely, as he was found directly next to the body. There is a possibility he threw it down swiftly after the murder. Speaking with Rickard, we can reveal a little more about the weapon.
That blaster? Never seen it before. Calder himself had a preference for Ichani weaponry. He had this one really nice light blaster rifle that he always used. Always wished I could get myself a rifle like the one he had.
Ichanis make delicate weapons with too little firepower. Lightweight stuff, if you ask me.
That blaster ain't it, though. Calder only had the one rifle, too, so he either must have borrowed that, or it's someone else's.
Calder only had one rifle. An Ichani light blaster rifle, to be exact. And the weapon found at the crime scene was not the same rifle. Perhaps it was stolen. Perhaps it even belonged to Rickard. We can also straight up accuse Rickard of killing Calder because of the bad business blood between them, and he seems to oddly just brush it off.
Now, I don't love Calder, but we go back a long way. We run a suborbital shipping and transport company out of Garang Spaceport. We've been partners in that business for well over 20 years. And we've been doing just fine the way we are. Right.
Incriminating. I'll be keeping a close eye on that. With the information dispersed from the droid and Rickard, that leaves Handan to have his say.
That blaster was stolen from my house last week. I never knew what happened to it. I hardly have enough money to afford a single blaster, let alone another. I can't tell you how important it is to have a weapon on hand with all these ravenous Kath Hounds around. Even an Irias can take a man down if it gets in the mood. Every settler has a weapon. It's our most prized possession. I would most appreciate it if I could have that back after you determine that Rickard is the killer.
Well, well, well. Isn't that just so coincidental? I suppose it adds up, considering Calder literally was in Handan's house, excuse my language, plowing his wife, so it's possible Calder could have stolen it. It is quite evident Calder wasn't the most upstanding citizen, judging among his actions, but I wish not to speak ill of the dead. I find it awfully coincidental that Handan's blaster was right next to the body, right next to where he was when the murder took place. This is all too fishy. We can then accuse Handan of killing Calder by using the cheating scandal against him.
Knock his block off, maybe, sure, but not kill him. I hope you don't find that incriminating. You know, normally I'm not prone to outbursts like that, but Calder, Mr. Medic, he was not a very nice person. Not a very nice person to me or my family. I had had my suspicions for several weeks, but had no proof until 2 days ago. It seems Calder was seeing my wife. Right under my nose, no less.
Well, if you can't keep her, it's your own fault.
But, as much as I may hate him for that, I could not kill him. It may have been my own fault for driving my wife away. I must try not to take the law into my own hands. I was just out running, trying to clear my head for the divorce proceedings, not stalking him to kill him. Running is not a crime.
Now, Handan states his blaster was stolen last week. It is standard protocol under Dantooine's government and the Jedi Enclave to report stolen items as soon as you can. We can check in with the droid to see if the blaster was reported missing.
I am sorry, but I seem to be failing you. I have searched and searched, but I cannot seem to come up with anything at all. I thought to find the record of the missing weapon report Mr. Gould filed with the authorities, but there does not seem to be one.
Aha! No report on a missing weapon. We'll take this back to Master Baluk. We can say Handan lied about the blaster being stolen, which leads us to the final piece of the puzzle. A blood sample was found on the blaster. It was sent to be analyzed and the results were relayed to the droid from the Enclave. This may be the smoking gun evidence we need to convict one of these men if the blood is not Calder's.
I have just received back an analysis of a sample of the blood found on the weapon. It had been sent back to the Enclave just before you arrived. The blood on the weapon is definitely not Calder's. Unfortunately, there was a bacterial contaminant in the sample that had been taken back to the laboratory, and it had become degraded. We cannot get any more specific analysis from that sample other than the fact it did not belong to Calder.
The blood was not Calder's. Who was standing right over the body? Handan. Whose blaster was it? Handan's. This is all adding up now. Keep in mind that Handan has also been clutching his side ever since we got here. There is suspicion of injury. When asking Handan about it, he says this.
Injured? No, of course not. Why would I have been? Fit as a bathtub. I don't know if I mentioned that.
Weird. We can tell Master Baluk of our findings regarding the blood sample. He asks who the blood would belong to if not Calder, in which we must make a decision between the two men. Now, one thing I did not mention previously is that Rickard injured himself running through the bush after the murder took place.
Well, I kind of sprained my ankle running through the bush before I found the body, but it's nothing that serious.
According to the National Health Service website for the UK, as well as mayoclinic.com, which is a weird website name, a sprained ankle is a result of the ankle being twisted in an awkward direction, resulting in the muscles inside the ankle, otherwise known as ligaments, to twist, stretch, or even rip. It is regarded as a common injury, and since it's an internal injury, would not result in any blood being drawn, unless a very rare, odd case. I do not think that Rickard's blood is at the scene of the crime, but Handan has been holding his side oddly since the very start of our investigation. We can ask Baluk about this detail.
Hey, what are you doing?
After it is revealed that Handan has suffered a blaster wound to the side, we are forced to make one of three decisions on who is guilty of the murder of Calder Nedek. Was it Handan Gould? Was it Rickard Lusoff? Was it both of them? Be sure to pause the video now, and comment down below who you think is the guilty one before we continue. If we agree that Handan is the guilty one, this happens.
I can leave now then.
What? No!
Tong abum sha umina.
Wangakumbe's king, Balimuraya. Chunyun tunjiji idadwana.
Kababot bambuji.
No! If I'm going, I'm not going alone. You don't know what you've done! Look, I came out here, I admit, to kill Calder. But so did Rickard. He must have thought it was Calder when he shot and hit me. So I'm going to prison, but I shouldn't be going alone. Did you idiots have to let the slime ball go?
Wow, what? We were wrong. It was both of them this whole time? Thinking logically, this does make sense as there are very, very clear motives for both. And now we can paint a full picture of what happened with this information. Calder was here before Handan showed up and killed Calder. And then Handan was shot by Rickard, who thought Handan was Calder. For time's sake, I'll skip the Rickard ending, as it's almost identical to this ending. Let us go to if we answer this quest correctly. Both are guilty.
You did good. You might just make a proper Jedi yet. Who knows?
Achuta. Gunga kun bis dolpi kikuniana.
And with that, we did it. Both men are convicted for their heinous crimes, and peace is partially restored to the Kunda Plains of Dantooine. I actually quite like this quest. Although it's only dialogue and there's no combat and there's pretty much nothing else to it once you've completed it a handful of times, I think this quest does a nice job at conveying the message that there's not just two sides to every story, but three. One perspective, another perspective, and the truth. Now, with that said, I do have some issues with this quest, however. My issues mainly stem from Baluk being a Jedi Master and being practically useless throughout the quest. I think it would be more sensible if he were a lower Jedi rank, with maybe a Jedi Master accompanying him, so there are two Jedi to accompany the player here. But I suppose this can also be justified by the fact that the player needs that Master-Apprentice connection to learn something from this quest. Even then, I don't think they do. If a Jedi learns only from their masters and not from their personal experiences, then how will they become a capable asset to the Jedi Order or the Republic at large? I feel like this is where the Jedi have went wrong time and time again, and it is reflected through both the story of KOTOR 1 and KOTOR 2. It was the Jedi that stood idly by and let the Mandalorians lay waste to planets outside of the Republic, forcing Revan to choose the path he did, and eventually turn to the dark side of the Force. Another issue with this quest I have is that I don't think it's ever disclosed whether both men are convicted, even if the player chooses otherwise. Baluk basically points the player in the right direction in the end, but by then, depending on their choice, Handan or Rickard are gone depending on the choice. Surely, a Jedi Master, of all people, would not let a guilty man roam free like that. Either way, this was the murder mystery of Caldanetic on Dantooine. I hope you enjoyed this quest run through, and wish to see more in the future. This is a style of video that's meant to act as a pilot episode to my newest section of content, Star Wars. I've been a big fan of Star Wars since I was 4 years old, and I wish to show you guys some Star Wars content. A lot of you seem keen on seeing KOTOR content, so I decided I would make a handful of videos to see how you react. Of course, if these are met with poor reception or you guys simply don't like it, I'll happily go back to being only a Fallout channel. And if you feel that way, please feel free to leave a comment. And for my Fallout fans, never fear. I have a Fallout video coming up right after this one. My video schedule plan is somewhat like KOTOR Fallout now. Or Star Wars Fallout, as I'm not just going to be covering KOTOR as one thing, I'm going to be covering most of Star Wars. Obviously, if people don't wish to see Star Wars content, this will be subject to change. Be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed, and subscribe if you're new. And most of all, may the Force be with you. Goodbye.